Where could that... I remember writing this. It's a story where you choose what happens.
Oh, yeah.
Wonder if I could still get to the end.
Choose your own adventure. Max and Chloe's sewer adventure. Oh, they made their own Choose Your Own Adventure by Maxine Caulfield and Chloe Price. Cool. I spent some time reading this. You are Max and Chloe. Well, I'm two people. The best friends and students in school. You sit in class until suddenly a cute squirrel arrives at the window. It is so cute. Do you want to pet it? Pet the squirrel, page 8. Don't pet the squirrel, okay? You go to the window and pet the squirrel. Of course, why wouldn't you? It's a cute squirrel, and you want to pet it. Hey, Mr. Squirrel, you say. Ah, stop biting me, you say next, because the squirrel is now biting your hand. But it's too late. You have rabies. Mrs. Andrews has to shoot you so you don't bite anyone else. This makes her very sad. Guess you shouldn't have pet the squirrel. The end. That's awesome. Don't pet the squirrel, page 3. I'm not going to cheat. Not yet, anyway. Why don't you like squirrels? They're so cute and nice. You must be very mean. Jeez. The squirrel seems annoyed that you ignored her. She runs in and steals the book report right off your desk, then runs back outside. That squirrel stole my book report, you tell the teacher. Uh-huh. Whatever you say, Mrs. Andrews responds, clearly not believing you. What do you do? Well, at least we're not dead from rabies. Chase the squirrel, page 4. As soon as Mrs. Andrews turns around, you run out the window and chase the squirrel. That is a very bad thing to do, and you hope you don't get in trouble later, but you probably will. Outside, you look around, but you can't find the squirrel. Is she gone? Oh, there she is. She's standing next to a sewer hole. You run up to her, but she gets scared and jumps down. Oh, boy. Do you really want to go down there? Jump down the sewer, page 2. You are very stupid, crossed out, brave. You leap down into the sewer. Thankfully, there's a pile of trash, banana peels, and dirty diapers to land on. Phew! And, P.U. You hear a squirrely sound in the distance, so you run to follow it. There are many twists and turns. Eventually, you... I love the illustrations. Eventually, you come to a fork in the road, but now's not the time for eating. So you... I was like, what? You put the fork back down and consider the two paths in front of you. That's funny. On the ground, you see a trail of tiny footprints to the left and a trail of chewed up paper to the right. Which way do you go? Let's go to the right. 7. Oops. Smart choice. You go to the right, following the path of chewed papers. After a bit of walking, you end up in a dark corner. Suddenly, the floor falls away. You find yourself swimming in some sort of warm liquid, almost like a big puddle, except... Why does this liquid taste like acorns? A bright light comes on. It turns out you're not in a puddle. You're in a big bowl of acorn soup. And around you are squirrels holding spoons and wearing tiny little aprons. They look so cute, and the soup keeps getting hotter. Guess you weren't too smart after all. At least you'll be delicious. The end. Let's go back to the crossroads. So we're going left then, page 9. That's awesome. You picked right. I mean left, which is right. It's confusing. In the distance, you see the squirrel, but he's not moving. In fact, he's dead. Who would kill a poor squirrel? Suddenly, the ground begins to shake. Around the corner, a giant rat appears. It's the biggest rat you've ever seen. The biggest anything you've ever seen. It's the Rat King. Oh, yeah, like from Fallout 2. The Rat King is wearing a crown and standing on a throne of all your missing homework, including your book report. What do you do? I'm gonna run towards it. Your dad always tells you to run toward your problems, not away from them. Unfortunately, you picked a really bad time to start listening to him. You run right towards the Rat King. At first, he seems surprised. You try to punch him in his face, but you forgot about his long, hairy, gross tail. It wraps you up like a boa constrictor and drops you into his mouth, swallowing you with one gulp. Now you get to see what the inside of a rat looks like. This would make a great science report. Too bad you won't be alive to tell anyone. The end. Alright, Rat King. Run away, page 5. You run awake like a scaredy cat. I don't blame you. That thing is gross. As you run, you almost trip on a small, shining object. You pick it up. It's a lighter. Your mom never lets you play with these, but she's not here right now, is she? Now is your chance to kill the Rat King and protect all the students' homework once and for all. This is your chance to be a hero. Do you do it? Just kidding, you don't get a choice. You may get to choose some things, but I'm still the author here. You have to attack the Rat King, but how do you want to attack him? Burn his tail, page 11. Nope, that's not a good idea. You decide to burn his gross, long, hairy tail. Good plan. Whoosh! The Rat King's tail is on fire. He does not like that one bit. He starts freaking out, waving his tail around like crazy. You know all the trash and dirty diapers in the sewer? Those are highly inflammable, which means the same as flammable for some reason. What? Suddenly, the entire sewer catches on fire. You're surrounded by gross sewer flames. Is this really how you die? Burning to death with the Rat King in a disgusting sewer? Yes, it is. The end. Foosh. Okay. Wait, that's not it. Okay, burn his throne, page 13. You decide to burn the Rat King's throne. It hurts you to burn all of that amazing homework, including your wonderful book report, but you remember that it's for a good reason. As soon as the throne catches on fire, the Rat King begins screaming, "No! My throne!" Suddenly the Rat King begins to shrink. Before long, he is back to the size of a normal rat. He can't even climb out of his huge crown. Aw, he's so cute now. You run back to class and tell Mrs. Anders all about the Rat King and everything that happened. Not only does she forgive you for not having your book report, but she declares that you are the greatest hero in the school. Duh. The end. Until the next Max and Chloe adventure. Okay, so that's a good ending. But there are some pages we haven't got to. So, Don't Pet the Squirrel is page 3. Stay in class, page 10. Let's check that out. You decide not to chase the squirrel. When the time comes to present your book report, you tell Mrs. Anders that a squirrel stole it and ran away. She doesn't believe you. Remember, I told you she doesn't believe you. Why didn't you listen? You should pay more attention. Anyway, Mrs. Anders reports you to the principal, and soon you are kicked out of school for being a bad student. Without school, you can never get a job or make money. Now you live in a shack without TV and do drugs. Soon you will be dead. Guess you should have paid attention. The end. Well, that's harsh. Okay, so we gotta chase the squirrel, page 4. Find another way, page 6. Another way down there. I don't blame you. That sewer hole looks pretty scary, but is there any other way down? Suddenly, a light bulb appears above your head. You use it to light the way back to your house and into your bathroom. You step 1 foot into the toilet and flush. Whoosh! Next thing you know, you are in the sewer. On the ground, you see a trail of tiny footprints to the left and a trail of chewed up paper to the right. Which way do you go? Well, this is the same left and right. Page 9 is the end. Oh, no. Page 9 is the Rat King. Page 7 is the end. Alright, so page 9. I'm gonna run away and go to page 5. I bet you there's an extra page that doesn't, like, lead any... Like, nothing leads to it. Yeah, right? Burn his throne, page 13. Is the end, right? Is there a page we haven't been to? Oh, really? They turned it in. This is so inventive, Maxine and Chloe, but next time, please do the book report you were assigned. Mrs. Anders. That's funny.
Oh, yes! Take that, Rat King.
That was awesome. Is she gonna say anything else about it? Let me see.
The Rat King was no match for us.
Cool. Yeah, eventually, once you pick the right page.
Don't move. This angle is perfect.
Why be shy? Get in here, dude.
Pose with Chloe.
Subject and photographer.
You really do it all, Max.
I try.
I want to see. Whoa! When am I going to see the... I guess we see the picture later.
I think this was the first class Chloe and I had together. Not sure I learned much about the stars and stripes.
The thing wouldn't be in here, would it? Oh, there was something sticking out. We might have found it.
Bingo.
Yeah, I might have missed some things. I didn't check the clothes. And I don't know what else. Cool. Chloe's secret lair. Dark cavern. The amulet is in there. The amulet's very happy. There's Treasure Island and Price Castle. Can I click on anything here? No.
I'm remembering this now. Didn't we make some crazy puzzle? We need the telescope and the amulet.
Which we hid inside a dark cavern, aka the attic!
Why did we do that to ourselves?
Because we were 8 years old and the attic was the scariest place we could think of.
Yeah. It's still scary.
Was. Your attic is still terrifying.
It's been 5 years, Max. I'm sure the boogeyman has died of starvation.
It's more the mice and spiders I'm afraid of.
Time to face your fears, then.
Okay, and once we have the amulet and the telescope, we use them to reveal the treasure. Somehow.
Here's what's happening. I'll head to the garage to dig up my old telescope. You go find that amulet. We'll meet out back at the pirate ship.
You mean the swings?
Huh.
Yes, the pirate ship. Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver right again, bitches!
Chloe seems so into this.
Yeah, really.
If this has to be my last day here, might as well have one final pirate adventure.
Oh, this is her last day? Why did I think she had a few weeks left or something?
Chloe said she hid the amulet in the attic. The only way in is through the broom closet.
Broom closet. Got it. Can we go back in?
Chloe's room has always been home base. It's hard to think this might be the last game we ever planned here.
Aww. Well, there's the broom closet. Of course, we'll check that out last.
Seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around the house. Makeup is great for acting in Halloween costumes. Any other time, I just don't get it. Chloe's mom bought me a toothbrush because I spend the night here so often.
Aw.
Well, I used to.
Haven't lately, or aren't going to anymore?
The things inside this cabinet haven't changed very much over the years.
There's hair dye that's not blue. Because we know Captain Bluebeard, we find out that blue is Chloe's favorite color. So.
I guess Chloe never really grew out of wanting to be a pirate.
Makes sense she dyed her hair blue later on. Anything else in here?
It's not my favorite place in the house, but I need to head to the attic.
In time.
I can't believe I won't be able to call Arcadia Bay home much longer. I don't think I've ever actually seen anyone reading these books. I wonder if I'll ever take this view in again.
I think you do, yeah. Come back. Oh, the loose post.
Slipped and broke this post a few years ago. But Chloe insisted on taking all the blame. Even after she got grounded, she never squealed. What a friend.
Why bother telling after you get grounded? It's too late. Let me just go through her parents' stuff.
It's awesome that Chloe's mom wants to teach kids. She'd be really good at it.
The College of Arcadia's Early Childhood Education Certification Program. Take the first step. Be the first step. Early childhood education is the first step towards lifelong learning. Night classes available. If this is what you want, we'll find a way to make it work. W. Is that from her husband?
Most strikes? How can that be so cool and so dorky at the same time?
Oh yeah, William Price. So this W is William. He's going through her friend's parents' room.
Chloe hasn't mentioned a trip. Maybe it's supposed to be a surprise. Oh, so cool.
Are we one of the ones on there? Well, there are 3 tickets, so I guess for her parents and her. It's going from Portland, Oregon to Phoenix, Arizona. I guess they travel to Portland? And then take the, I'm guessing, the plane?
Chloe is such a nature nerd. I bet she's gonna love it.
Visit the Grand Canyon. Bike and Jeep tours available daily. 277 miles of beauty. You know, the Grand Canyon is not close to Phoenix. Just gotta say, it's about 3 hours away, I think. Several hours. Leave it at that. Nicotine gum? I'll look at the nicotine gum first.
Chloe's mom is trying to quit smoking.
Cigar quit gum. Take control back. Nicotine gum. 12 pieces of nicotine gum. See back for medical warnings. Okay, let's see the back. Oh. I knew that wouldn't work.
Is that an email from the principal at Blackwell? Chloe did act a little strange when I asked her about school earlier.
Yeah, she's not getting along with people there, apparently.
The principal at Blackwell wants to meet with Chloe's parents. I wonder what about.
To William Price and Joyce Price from Ray Wells. Yeah, Principal Wells. Meeting this week. Hello, Mr. and Mrs. Price. I would like to begin by saying we are thrilled to have Chloe at Blackwell. Rest assured, her scholarship is not in jeopardy at this time. However, it seems that she's having trouble transitioning into this new, more challenging environment. I'm emailing to set up a time to talk about the incident that occurred last week. I'm very concerned about Chloe's behavior and would like to work with you to take steps to correct it as soon as possible. I'm sure you are as dedicated to Chloe's success here as we are. The future needs excellence. Oh God. Regards, Ray Wells. Cheesy.
Get into a fight? She never gets in trouble. I'm glad her dad stood up for her.
Chloe doesn't take any crap. So this is from Ray Wells to Joyce Price. Ray, Chloe's was not the student to act out that day, and if you ask me, Marissa Rogers isn't the victim, she's the bully. Maybe if both sides of the story were heard before placing blame, your school would be a less challenging environment for your students. Focus on your school, I'll focus on my daughter. Okay, so that was her response.
A voicemail? I wonder if it's still there.
To Joyce Price. Subject, voicemail for you. These types of people are exactly why I didn't want Chloe at Blackwell. We'll figure this out, I promise. I love you too. From Joyce Price. I forgot to tell you, Mrs. Rogers called while you were out yesterday and left a message. It's still on the answering machine, but please be careful when you listen to it. I don't want Chloe to overhear. We need to figure out how to handle this. I know the principal said her scholarship isn't in danger, but I still worry. Love you. I guess that's from Joyce to her husband.
Sometimes I really wish I had siblings.
To Aaron Price from William Price. Thanks for the pressure washer. Finally used your pressure washer today, and I just wanted to say thanks again for letting me borrow it. Works like a charm. It's not our dream house, but now it can at least be the right color. If you want to come over next weekend and give me a hand, there'll be a cold beer in it for you. Give me a call. Hope everything at work is still going well. And tell Linda I say hello, William. Oh, I didn't know she had an older brother. Alright, so we can check the answering machine downstairs. If we can even go downstairs yet.
Oh, Chloe's parents are so cute.
Yeah. San Francisco holidays, I guess, with William and Chloe. I don't think it's science fiction.
The Two Whales makes the best Belgian waffles. No other diner could even come close.
Hmm. Can I walk in here? I can, but there's no reason to. What are you doing in our room? Uh-oh. I thought I got stuck there. It's a book!
I don't think I could ever handle a real-life murder investigation.
Tollbridge, an Oliver Sharp mystery. You'll pay with your life. By Ed... Oneida? Oneida?
I always like to imagine I could open that wardrobe and step into another world.
Yeah, right? The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe? Alright, so that's it for this room. Can I go downstairs yet?
I've gotta find that amulet before I meet Chloe out back.
Okay. Find the amulet.
The entrance to the Dark Cavern is in there. Bluebeard's chosen hiding place for the mysterious amulet.
Hmm. Okay, let's see how spooky this place is.
There it is. The Dark Cavern.
Hmm.
Crap. I can't get into the attic if I can't even reach the door. I need to find something to stand on. I'm sure I can find something around here to boost me up.
Like a crate?
Maybe this will make me tall enough to reach.
Maybe. Nope.
It's a start. I gotta find something I can stack on top of it.
A human body.
I think that'll be a good base to stack things on.
Okay, looks like something not in this room then. The toolbox?
It seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around the house.
Well, Towelie isn't gonna help. Put it on top of something else. Hmm.
Almost there. We just need a few more inches.
No, give it a try like it is.
Not bad for an improvised stepladder, but it's still not tall enough.
You're really short. We can't use a toolbox. Stand on a trophy. Let's take their computer. This? It's a box. We can use it.
I just need a few more inches to reach the attic.
You sure do. Maybe some books? Yeah.
If I stack a bunch of books on the stool, I could probably reach the attic.
Is she gonna fall to her doom? Let's see. Let's find out. That looks pretty precarious.
I think that should be tall enough.
Look one last time.
Should be stable enough. Besides, what's adventure without a little risk?
Here goes. Should put it more in the middle. Ooh, the Dark Cavern. Three till what? Here be spiders, you may touch.
Awesome. Man, there is a ton of stuff up here. How will I ever... There it is.
That's it? Okay.
Of course Chloe hid the amulet in the hardest place to get to. I need to find a way through.
Okay. Looking at stuff all the while.
No Sharpie boob jobs. Disappointing.
Yeah. It's more like a Def Leppard or Poison type of band. Three till what? Man, these camera angles are a little cramped.
Her parents couldn't part with this. I guess I see where Chloe gets her sentimentality from.
Old TV?
I remember it took this thing like 100 years to rewind the land before time.
Takes a long time to rewind time. Old chair.
I can't get through with this chair here.
Then push eat.
I think I can squeeze through now.
Squeeze through where? Oh. She's pretty small, so. Amulet of Yendor. What you got?
Not a single country record. These must belong to Chloe's mom.
Why the hell do we want a country record? Those are nasty.
It's a good thing I'm big and burly.
Oh, you are?
Otherwise, moving this furniture would be kinda difficult.
I'm not pulling it yet. I'm gonna look around.
I need to move that cooler, but this desk is in the way.
Christmas box.
That's full of decorations Chloe made when she was 5. She thinks they're embarrassing, but I think they're cute. I remember this. Chloe refused to get another goldfish after she had to flush Calico Jack.
He took the final adventure in the deep sea.
I need to move that desk, but this dresser is in the way.
Okay. Big and burly, huh? Is she grabbing on the bottom of it?
One step closer. I've gotta get through, which means this desk has gotta move.
Just climb over it. You can climb over that.
Ugh, this desk's pretty heavy.
I would literally just crawl over that thing.
This looks like it used to be a nice desk. I guess everything ends up in an attic eventually.
Did she say anything new about the dresser now?
Oh, I remember when Chloe and I decorated this. More like destroyed it.
The cooler?
I never realized how much I liked vintage things. This cooler is awesome.
Yeah, I like it. I like to pull on it, too.
Glad this thing is empty.
I still have to pull it?
I'm so close, but I still can't get to the amulet.
We must select pull again. Good enough now?
Yes.
She answered me. I'll whip back. Okay. Anything else to say about the cooler?
You are now free to move about the attic.
It's like this is a cooler saying it. Record player.
Not a single country record.
Oh, never mind.
These must belong to Chloe's mom.
I didn't realize it was a record player. I thought it was just a stack of records before. Alright, so now we can go through here. The good thing she's tiny. Sorry, I meant big and burly. The amulet! Anything else to look at? Apparently not. Oh, there's a photo, actually. Oh, take a photo. Let's look at it.
A fitting reward for a journey full of treasures. This is a nice close-up shot.
Is it like something they made, like one of those bake things that you can bake the crystals or something together?
A fitting reward for a journey full of treasures.
Alright, so we take.
Got you. This thing is cool, I guess. I wish I could remember how it works.
Oh, we attach it to the telescope? Uh-oh.